Hey everybody, in this video we're going to go over a quick test you can do at home that's been shown to predict your overall level of health and actually how long you're going to live. So it's a quick and easy check-in you can do at home. I'm going to show it to you right now. My name is Rob Drenning, I'm a physical therapist. Thank you for checking out this channel, I really appreciate it. If you find this information helpful, if it's useful to you, please like and please subscribe. It helps me get it out to more people. I really appreciate you. So, we're going to talk about this test. It's called the sit to rise test. It became really popular. A doctor in Brazil came up with it, and over 10 years ago, he published his first study where he followed people ages 50 to 80, so older adults, and he followed them for years. He had them perform this test, he scored them, and he tracked how long they were going to live. And what he found was interesting. It was that people who scored lower on this test actually were 5 to 6 more times more likely to die within 5 years. Pretty interesting, huh? Pretty interesting. So it's called the sit to rise test. We have to think about those results cautiously though, because obviously the people who didn't score as well were closer to that 80 range and they're more likely to pass away anyway. So maybe it's not just the test result, but overall it's just a glimpse into the picture of what your overall health can look like. So as we go through the test and think about our score, we also want to think about our score related to our age, because just from that first study it's really hard to figure out. So fortunately in 2020 another study came out that came up with age related norms for us all over the age of 20 all the way up into the 80s to 90. So they came up with percentiles. I'll post a link to the chart in the description so you can have that and look and check your score based on your age, based on your gender, and see if you're within the normal range. They broke it into quarters, I think. If you're in the top 25, the bottom 25%, or if you're kind of in the middle. So younger people obviously tended to do better, and of course, women did a little better too. So I'll post that chart, take your score with this test, and check that out to see where you fall. Okay, so it's called the sit to rise test. And the gist of the test is you want to sit down and stand back up without using your hands, without using your knees, basically using nothing else to touch or get support. So I'm going to show you how that looks right now. So I'm just trying to sit down without using my hands. So for me, I'm going to cross my feet. I'm going to reach forward and I'm just going to slowly sit down like that onto the floor. Okay. And I'm going to do the same thing standing back up. That's it. That's the test. Simple. Now, scoring, that's the tricky part. So let's go over that right now. Basically, you start out with a score of 10, and every time you have to touch a hand, a knee, whatever down, you lose a point. So if I'm going down like this, and I have to touch a hand, I lose a point. If I have to touch a knee, I lose another point. If I have to put my hand on my knee, I lose a third point. Okay, so the score can go down quickly. And then when you're coming back up, if I have to touch anywhere, I lose a point for each place that I touch. If I stumble, lose my balance, you lose another half point for that. Okay, so that's how you score. 10 points, you lose a point for each thing you use going down. You lose a point for each point of contact you have going up, and a half a point if you lose your balance. Okay, does that make sense? So that's how you score, and you want to interpret these results cautiously. I really want to make sure you guys understand this point. So use your score and reference it to how old you are. Look at that chart in the description, okay? But interpret it cautiously. If you're on the low end, please don't assume you're going to die next week, okay? That's not what this test is saying. All it's saying is if you're low, you need some more strength, some more mobility, some more flexibility. You just need more exercise and physical fitness in your life. And that's okay. You can improve those things at all times. And we also want to keep in mind, if you have any musculoskeletal conditions, like let's say you had a knee replacement, for example, you're probably going to score terribly on this test, right? Also doesn't mean you're going to die in 5 years, right? There are other things that contribute to it. There are multiple factors that really determine how fit, how healthy you are, and what your true mortality is going to be like, okay? This test isn't the end all be all. It's just a snapshot. It's just a quick snippet, something you can do quick and easy at home just to see where you stand and really just to see if you need more work or if maybe you're pretty good. So it's called the Sit to Rise test. Let me know what your score is. Let me know how it goes in the comments. Any questions, any concerns, I want to know how it goes for you. You can click on my picture here to subscribe and check out some of these other videos as well. Thank you.